afternoon to everybody. I am Alma Yu, the sister of Jojo, as you call him in California. We are 10 siblings in the family. Jojo was the youngest among men, sa aming lalaki, and I am the youngest sa babae. As we grow older, when I was in college and he was also in Baguio, we tried to discover the transformation in him. Kasi when he was in Cotabato City, medyo mabarkada and all that as a typical teenager. So, nung nasa Baguio na siya, he changed to a mature one as I know him, kasi there was a chance na nagbakasyon ako sa Baguio after I graduated in college. So there, I realized he's a different man from what I used to know during our younger years. And then most of his life, Jojo spent outside Cotabato City. He went to Baguio, he went to Dubai together with my sister Joy, because my sister Joy was always with him during those years of his adulthood. So when Ate Joy was in Baguio, he was also in Baguio. When Ate Joy was in Dubai, he was in Dubai. So he was always tagged by my ate. The rest of his life, he spent in California, in U.S., as he raised his family there. So we seldom talk, only telephone, only long distance was the communication that we had. And the vacation when they went to Cotabato or in Davao for vacation. And usually, it would take only 5 days the most para magbakasyon at magbisita kay mama at papa sa parents and to the rest of the siblings. As we grew older, we try to talk mature things. That's the transformation I discovered from him. 2018, when my mother died, so he was here in Davao. And then, a year after, he called me up and told me that he was sick. Although the sickness was, for me, I took it positively that it was not that intense. It was not that, yung hindi naman ganun ka problema, because there are a lot of people that I know also had those ailments, but in God's grace, they survived and still a life ahead of them. So that was, I accept his ailment. But deep in my heart, upon knowing that he was ill, it really broke my heart. When he went to Cebu for a vacation, for a reunion on his wife's side, and he called me up, because that was the time when he was already in that condition, he usually called me. He usually called me by long distance and update me on his situation. So from then on, I could have a status of his condition. When he was in Cebu, he called me up and talked to me and telling me that I have to go to Cebu to look at him and mag-usap. So we traveled to Cebu together with my sister, Ate Luz, and a cousin of mine. There, I saw him. We talked a lot for almost stayed for, I think, 4 days just to check his condition and talk of many things. Thereafter, they went to Davao City to talk with my other siblings regarding his conditions. So we had a long talk and a meeting with my elder brothers and elder sisters. Then afterwards, they go back to California for his treatment and go back to their regular lives. On the following years, on the following months, I called him and asked for his condition. Most of the time, I would chat, "Kumusta?" That's the least word I would always talk to him in a chat. "Kumusta? And how are you eating?" Those were the words I usually talk. Those were the words that I usually ask him, "How are you eating and how are you doing?" He would always call me to talk of many things, the usual. His pains, his stress, and would always say, "Pag nawala siya, he would like to be with my mother's side in Davao." At first, I would not entertain that. Hindi ko ini-entertain yung ganung idea because that was very far from reality. Sabi ko, it's not you who decide for yourself, but rather it's the one who create us that would decide for ourselves. But for several times that we would talk, I became immune. Medyo na-use na ako sa ganun yung sinasabi. So I would say, "Saan mo gusto?" "Yes, oo, ganun." Ganun ang sinasagot ko sa kanya. Until there are times na tumatawag siya and magkwento. This past few days, we had a group chat created by Beth. So thereon, namomonitor namin ang condition niya because we were updated by Beth. I usually don't look at the video, but I would tell my children and my husband to look it for me, to look at the video in behalf of me, because it would be somehow heavy on my part. Then, there are times when I pray, when we pray, or Jojo was in that condition for more than 2 years. And never would I fail in my prayers every time I go to church that I would not pray for his recovery. And even on the last few days, these past few days, when I go to church, I would ardently ask that even the 1 hour of celebrating Mass, of celebrating Eucharistic celebration with the Lord, that those 1 hour may free from his pain. Kahit yung isang oras lang ng Mass, ibigay lang yun na walang sakit siya maramdam. Yun yung prayer na binabangkit ko. Until the last, this 2-3 days ago, August 6th here, I think August 5th in your area, a bet chat me that he was calling my name. So I chat back and told Beth that I would like to talk to him. And Beth told me na hindi siya maka-istorya. I told Beth, even hindi siya maka-istorya, just let the cell phone listen my voice. Just let the cell phone put in his ears and I would like to talk to him. So I was in the office and I talked to him. I talked to him if he is in pain and God is with him. God will never abandon him. Hindi siya pabayaan. Just believe and trust in him. Because nandiyan siya sa anumang oras at anumang lugar. You just have to cling unto him. And I told him. And he would utter, maybe because of his pain. Until we stopped talking because he was really in pain. The following day, a day after that, a vet called. So, pag magtawag si vet, I could feel something. So, I called back and nakita ko, he was lying in bed, sleeping. So, sabi ni vet, he was in coma. But never did it occur in my mind that he was in coma. I was telling na he was asleep. I was telling myself na he was asleep because of the pain reliever he took up. When I was looking at him in the bed, there are always hesitations of talking to him and seeing him. Because in our minds, we would like to imagine that he is still healthy and in good condition. So, pag nakikita, it pains so much na makita siyang frail and everything. So, yun yung hesitations why we don't always call him. At ano, because nandun yung fear and parang hindi ma-take na makita siyang nag-ganong condition. But on his last day, I was looking at him in bed, sleeping. Nakikita ko na there was peace. He was sleeping peacefully. And nothing had changed so much in his physical body. So I looked at him. I told Beth na I would like to look at him even he's sleeping. And even told Beth na wala naman palang nagbago sa katawan niya. He was still the same. Yun lang pumuti yung kanyang hair. So we talk of several things ni Beth. Nasa likod lang siya, sleeping. And Beth told him na, Dad, Alma is here. And he had to, So parang sabi ni Beth, anaduhog ka niya ay. Sabi ko, sige lang kasi his senses, his hearing, is still active. Because that's the last sense of a human to fail. Yun yung pinakahuling nag-fail. So when Beth tumayo siya kasi may ginawa siya, naiwan kami dalawa. So I look at him and told him, pagod ka na. Wala ng pain. Wala ka ng pain na nararamdaman. Tulog na muna, sabi ko. Sleep ka muna, tulog ka muna, and then later, magising lang kaya wala ng pain. Anyway, sabi ko sa kanya, mawala lang din yung pain. So, as I was talking to him, he was asleep. He was sleepy. And then afterwards, I told Beth na mag-rest na muna siya. And then I just call up later and I would call my siblings to call him. Sabi ko yung mga kapatid ko na tawagan siya. So that was it. My pamangkin was calling me. Nag-video call kami ng pamangkin ko. So medyo busy yung phone ko because nag-video call kami ng pamangkin ko regarding Uncle Rim's status. So while nag-uusap kami, tumawag naman yung sister-in-law ko. Hindi ko masagot yung sister-in-law ko because busy yung line ko. I told my husband to answer my sister-in-law. And then while nag-uusap kami ng pamangkin ko, my husband tell me na he told me na Rim has passed away. So that was the time I was being hysterical and crying. Really, I cried hard. Although, before those days, I was already, we tried to condition my life. Even the siblings, even the magkakapatid, the pamangkins, the family, we were trying to condition ourselves that we have to give up. Kasi kung mahihirapan si Jojo, mahihirapan kami, much more si Jojo, who is nagdadala ng kanyang sarili. Ang sabi ko nga, when I was trying to write, knowing the thought of knowing that that you are sick really broke my heart. The ordeal that you have gone through for the past 2 years and more than pains us so much. But the final reckoning has come that our lives here on earth is not ours. So be with him where there's no pain, no agitations, but all joy and happiness. We'll be joining from Mama for the rest of our siblings who have gone, and be happy. Sabi nga nila, he was young. But I remember Cardinal Villegas in one of his homily that it is not how young or how old we die, but how we live in this world. And him, you are now with the Lord and rest easy. In behalf of George's family, we would like to say thank you to Beth and Ion, who stayed with him during those trying times. Thank you. Thank you very much, and good day to everybody.